been a little too bright. You know, Paul, my memory is that this is kind of what happened last year, that we started off with a pretty good amount of rain. It was promising, and then it shut off.
I think that was 2 years ago, because last year we didn't have anything up until mid-November, and then it was just little spits here and there. But 2019, that rainy season was really affected by that rain-free February, where we got just absolutely nothing. We will hope that as we head from November into December that the rainy season kind of picks back up. But it's not going to happen in the next 7 days. But on the bright side, it means that's plenty of opportunity to get out and put up the holiday lights. Plenty of my neighbors are out doing that today. Passing clouds overnight, nothing falling out of those clouds. The rain chances still pushed way to our north. Yet another round of rain making its way into the Pacific Northwest over the next 24 to 36 hours. For the Bay Area, for most of California, high pressure in control over the weekend, which means calm weather, above average temperatures continuing. But the fact it's going to be right on top of this, that means what's left of that surface level smoke, which did disperse a little bit today, is still going to be trapped in place for the next several days. At its worst, the air quality was in the unhealthy for sensitive groups, the orange category for inland parts of the East Bay and the Santa Clara Valley. It has since improved for much of the Bay Area, but at its worst over the next several days, we're going to be in the yellow category. That's moderate. It's not enough to trigger a spare the air alert, and as the wind shifts things around a little bit, there are going to be times when the air quality does improve, but whenever the wind calms down, all that stuff just settles back down to ground level. Looking outside, just a beautiful perspective of the last rays of light on the horizon as we look to the north from Salesforce Tower. Temperature is at 57 degrees downtown, cooling off a little bit. 60 degrees right now in Concord, at 62 degrees in San Jose. That is the warm spot on the map, at upper 50s, low 60s. That's not bad for a November evening. Temperatures later on tonight are going to drop down mostly to the low to mid 40s inland, with mid to upper 40s to near 50 degrees around the bay. A normal November night and early morning. And then high temperatures tomorrow are still going to be warm. We're talking highs 5 to 10 degrees above average. The warmest spots are once again going to be in the Santa Clara Valley, up into the low 70s for San Jose. Let's zoom in for a closer look. You're going to hit the mid 60s, even along the coast, right around 70 degrees down the peninsula and around the south end of the bay, farther and farther into the 70s as you go inland in the Santa Clara Valley. You'll be the warm spots on the map until you get farther north towards Mendocino and Lake Counties. I'll show you that in a second. For the East Bay, temperatures are going to reach up into the mid to upper 60s inland, also mid to upper 60s bayside, with temperatures in Oakland reaching up to about 68 degrees, just a couple degrees cooler in San Francisco, but that's 5 degrees above normal. Upper 60s to around 70 degrees for the North Bay, and then some even warmer temperatures as we look farther north, up to 74 degrees for Cloverdale and Ukiah, even temperatures around 70 degrees for Lakeport and Clear Lake, with temperatures running pretty steady as we head through the rest of the weekend. So if you're heading to the Niners game on Sunday, 1:25 kickoff against my Vikings, temperatures are going to be in the upper 60s. It's going to be sunny. It's going to be mild. Please be nice to all the people wearing purple. Be polite. We've had a rough year. Temperatures are going to stay steady, and rain chances are going to stay steady as well for the next several days. But we do have some signs of hope a couple weeks down the line. This is the 8 to 14 day outlook from the Climate Prediction Center, a signal towards above average precipitation for Northern California. And while we're not looking at a significant chance of above average rainfall for the Bay Area, at least our odds are going to even out and get some chances of rain in here as we head through the second week of December and into the second weekend of December. But that's still a long way down the line. Temperatures are going to run pretty steady, just a little baby cool down Monday and Tuesday, but temperatures are going to bounce back Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, running about 5 degrees above average to start off the month of December around the bay, with temperatures closer to 10 degrees above normal farther inland. And other than some passing clouds Monday and Tuesday, nothing changing in the skies overhead. So the haze is still trapped at ground level. We need some rain to kind of wash that stuff out of the atmosphere. But with no rain in sight for at least the next 10 days, we're just going to have to kind of be stuck with that haze on the horizon.